Welcome everybody to a brand new series called Hidden Folks. I don't think you all know the extreme excitement in my voice of how bad I have wanted to share this game with you. I discovered this game a couple of weeks ago and I have been hooked on it for days now. It is like a hide and go seek type of game, and it is so originally unique to it that I can't even put it into words. It is so unique and funny because the sounds are all made by voices instead of actual everyday sounds that you would hear, and it's so good. And it can be challenging because things are hidden and you have to look for them, and you have to sit there and diligently look under things and cut things down and that kind of thing. It is so unique to the name Hidden Folks. So I played a bit of it. As you can see, these little indications right here show that I played quite a bit and completed some of these, and these were tough. Some of these were very easy and some of these were very tough. And I'm currently on this one. I'm halfway done in coloring that little dot right there. And I hope you guys enjoy this series, and I'm not going to hold it longer, so let's go ahead and just kind of finish up on the one that I'm working on right now. These sounds are hilarious. These sounds are just so crazy. So as you can see, we're in a campground type of area, and we can zoom out, we can click and drag and look around. I'm going to move slowly because if you move quickly, it throws you off. But you can zoom in and look at these little people, and as you zoom in, you can hear sounds. Listen. And as you move in different areas, different sounds flow into different parts of the area. So right now we're hearing this area, but if we zoom into like this area, and if I open up this tent, watch this. The music is supposed to play. Look at that! It's a trip. It is a trip. It's so crazy. So down here is where you have things listed that tells you the things you or the people you're supposed to be looking for, and it gives you hints. When you click on this one, for example. When you click on this one, it tells you Beekeeper Barry is being terrorized by bees. So stop stealing their honey, man. Just cute little things right there. But you have to read in order to tell you exactly where to look. It gives you hints or tips to kind of look. So obviously, if I zoom out of this map, if I zoom out and look around, I have to find an area where I can possibly find bees or something like that. And if I look to the left as I move this map, there's these little areas here where there's bees. And if you zoom in, you can listen. You hear that? I hear bees. So obviously he's in here in this section somewhere. And I did find him. If you look at the person right there, what you're looking for, you can just go by how that person looks, and you can find them. And they can be hidden behind things like this grass. You see that? The sounds that these things make, they can be hidden behind these things. Look at that. Everything has a sound. It is incredible. It is absolutely incredible. So the guy that I'm looking for is actually right here. I actually found him already. He's right here. Well, that should be him. Well, anyway, I found him because there's a little check mark under him. When you find him, they get a little check mark up under them. So I found him. He's somewhere. That's probably not him. That looks like him. Well, then whatever. I found him. So anyway, I'm looking for somebody right now. So right now I'm looking for, and it gets harder. Because some of these things get small and they get really hidden in these things. Now, you can go into the settings. I will show you some of the settings. Doot. If it hurts your eyes. Doot. You can go on the settings. Bring down the volume just a little bit. You can control the scroll sensitivity. You can control the brightness if it's too bright. Bring down the brightness a little bit. And it's actually a little bit too bright for me, actually. Bring that down a little bit. You can change the color. Toggle the color. Doot. See that? And adjust it to whatever you want it to be. You can change the language. So this comes in different languages, so this is great. You can toggle the interface size of everything, so you can make it big for you to you can see. or make it small, however you want to do it. I might have it big like that, actually. And change the interface position to the bottom or to the top, however you want to do it, or reset a level. So however you want to do it. And this seems much better, actually. It's pretty big. That's pretty big. I can actually see. That's actually better for me, actually, for my eyeballs. Okay, so let's click on this one. I got two more things I need to find. These sounds are incredible. Tortoise Raphaelio. I'm not saying his name right. Tortoise Raffaello. Raffiet. Whatever. Dries in the sun. Okay, so I'm looking for a turtle. Dries in the sun. Okay. A turtle drying in the sun. And I think these people are villagers? I don't know. They come off like villagers. He dries in the sun. Okay, let's zoom out a little bit. I don't want to zoom out too much because then I won't be able to see the tortoise. I want to say turtle. The tortoise. He dries in the sun. Would he be near water? And you have to look. Let me zoom in. And click on things. And he might be in the water. He might be behind these rocks or under people. He might be in a tree. He might be in this car. He might be in this log. I mean, you have to click on things. There's bunnies in this hole. He might be in this hole. I mean, you have to actually look. Oh, wait. There was an area of people laying on the towel. Maybe that's where he would be. Because some of these hints, they tell you this, and your brain will think, oh, it would be in the most obvious place. But in actuality, they would be in the most unobvious place. Like, that turtle might be under these X's. Let's dig. What was that? Okay, that's a bottle. All right. That was nothing. Is there something here? Anybody lose a pickaxe? Nobody lost a pickaxe? All right, so this turtle is on its back, laying on its back. So I need to find a turtle laying on its back somewhere. This is a beach. Would it be on these umbrellas? Oops. Go back there. Let me read that again. Tortoise Raffaello. Whoa. Dries in the sun. Whoa. These sounds, man. Dries in the sun. The only place I could think of was over there where the people were on the beach towel. Would he be in this parking lot? Now, this one dude, I will tell you this. This one dude right here in the bottom right here next to the turtle. This one was crazy. He hitched a ride. Ivan hitched a ride without permission and doesn't have an escape plan. My sister and I was trying to figure that one out. And I was like, wait a minute. Obviously, he's in a car or a boat. And we was at that for like 15 minutes. We were stumped. And it turned out, I said, wait a minute, would he be in the trunk of a car? And we were clicking on everything, and it turns out he was hidden in a trunk. In one of these trunks. One of these trunks, he was in it. And Lord knows, that's where he was. I'm telling you, the craziest thing, where is this turtle? Where is this turtle? Lord, he's drying in the sun. The turtle is drying in the sun. So I'm looking at places near water. Okay, that was a hole there. Ain't nobody looking for no leaf. Okay. Let me zoom in here. There's a lake here. I'm staying near water because I'm thinking that's where the turtle would be. Okay. I'm clicking on the boat. Would he be... Okay. Oh, we're next to the porta johns. You can hear people going print, pooping. That's disgusting. You can hear that. Okay, he's got to be near some water. That turtle has got to be near some water. He's drying in the sun. He's drying in the sun. Oh my gosh. Dries in the sun. Would he be in a desert-like area? Would he be in a... What's this? Food. Okay. Now these are all bees. What are you doing behind there? Nothing. There's an alligator. Nothing. There was one item that was actually had gotten eaten up by a snake, and I had to click on the snake in order for that snake to spit it out. You talk somebody mad. I was trying to find that one item, and it was inside of a dumb, stupid snake. It was on the previous levels. That took a minute to figure out. Let's see. It dries in the sun. All right, let's go up here. He wouldn't be underground, so I don't know why I'm clicking on all the X's. So he wouldn't be underground, but the turtle is drying in the sun. So it must be somewhere that's really... Somebody hidden in the tree. Okay, no. It must be somewhere really exposed. Oh, I found you, bat. Yeah, I found you. There was a monster. Would it be in the ground? No, that's a flower. Would it be in here? No. Oh, my gosh! Where is this turtle? What is that right there? Nothing. That turtle is probably staring me right in my face. Okay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave you now and try to find this stupid turtle. And then I'm going to come back to you, okay? So give me just a minute. Well, I certainly found it. What kind of hiding place? It was right here. There it is. So when you find the freaking creature or the object you're looking for, you just click on it. Found him. Bing. And you get a check mark. So we found Rafaelio, or however you say his name. Oh, he was upside down. Didn't even see him. He prefers to stay dry. Dries in the sun, but he ain't drying in no sun. He drying in the water. What? Anyway, what is this? This spider has particular taste for fungus flies. Fungus flies? Fungus flies. Fungus flies? Would it be over here? These look like beehives. No, there it is, right there. Found it. Found it. So when you completed everything, even if you don't complete everything, when you can find most of the stuff down here, you'll unlock the next level. So that's what happens. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into the next level. We won't finish the whole thing, but we're going to go into the next level and see what we can do there. So let's see. Found everything here. And we can either stay here and click on things and see how things interact, or we can go into the next thing. So the next thing is do some farming. Oh, this is new. So I have not gotten this far. So what you've seen is me finish up where I left off. Okay. Farmer Wyatt takes his job as wheat supervisor very seriously. Okay, so this is what Farmer Wyatt looks like. He's a man sitting down with a pitchfork, and he is hidden somewhere. So let's find his big head. Right there. There he is. So you'll get some that are very easy, and then you'll get some that are very hard, like what we just left. Pitchfork versus hay. 0.1 pitchfork versus hay. Now, you got these pitchforks, but that don't count. You need a single pitchfork. Ooh, I made your water hose turn on. Found it. It was under hay bale. Bling. And then, if you water your crops well and give them a little bit of extra attention, you may see this rare flower. Ooh, ooh. Let's keep watering. Okay, guess not. Wait, is it hidden here? These sounds are great. Do I have to keep watering? I probably shouldn't have grown that. Because I'd have never found what you call it if he was there. Anything? Okay. Nothing there. I'm hearing sounds out my window in real life. What happens if I keep Oh, you click on it. Oh! One of these has got to be the red flap. It's that one. Found it! Oh my goodness. Do you see what I'm saying? You have to interact with these things to make stuff grow. That is crazy. Well, anyway, you guys, I hope you guys like this first episode of Hidden Folks. It's so wonderful. Let me know what you think below. Leave a like on this video. It really does help me out quite a bit. And just let me know if you want to see more. I would love to give you guys more of this game. It is truly a joy to play. And like I said, the sounds alone will just have you cracking up. It's so great. So if you like it, let me know. And I will see you in the next episode of Hidden Folks.